Hello everyone, my name is Khaleesi and welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel if this is your first time tuning into one of my videos. Today I am bringing you once again a kind of family, well actually no, it's not really a family home at all. I'm bringing you another speed build in The Sims 3, and it is a house that when I started building it, I kind of intended it for, or I intended for it to be for a small family, and I guess you could make this a tiny family home, but I think instead I'll call it another quotation marks starter home. Yeah, I don't know. That just kind of feels like it fits the description of the house the easiest. So it's a starter home without the starter home price. So I don't know. I would kind of consider this a house that I would move my Sims into when they just age up into a young adult. So like, you know, as their first little home outside of their parents' home and stuff like that, I would use this house for those kinds of Sims. And also to downgrade, I guess, if I have elders or something. Actually, no, I don't do anything with like special with my elders ever. My elders literally stay in the same house until they're dead. So yeah, this could be for an elder Sim. I don't know. It could be for an elder couple if you treat your elders a little bit better than I do. I just sort of leave them where they are until they die. But yeah, this would work for an elder couple. It would work as like I said, your Sim's first little stepping stone into the real world. You could even, if you just have one child, it could work as a family home. It is very small, so yeah, it's I don't know. I feel like I'm doing a little bit better at combining my love of tiny homes and also like playability, you know what I mean? Because I was doing these really, really tiny homes for a while and they only ever had one bedroom, and they could only, a lot of the time, those one bedroom homes that I was doing, they had beds that were pushed up against the wall. So you literally could actually only have one Sim live there. Which obviously not a lot of people play with just one Sim, so yeah, the playability of those houses is not the best, but yeah, I'm trying to make my builds more usable. I'm also building a lot of houses because I'm really, really invested in my current household at the moment. I posted a video of them the other day and I stream them every single day. You don't need me to tell you that because I tell you in like every single video. But since I've been playing with my Sims so much, obviously I need houses for all of them. So yeah, I've kind of been trying to build some more like functional homes for my own sake as well. So we're all benefiting out of this. But yeah, I don't know if I've mentioned it already, it is a two bedroom home. I feel like I did. I haven't recorded a commentary in a while. I actually I haven't really functioned properly in like the past week, to be honest with you. The reason for it is I currently don't have a shower in my house, so I don't know. I sort of, I don't know why not having a shower in my house has made me like just stop functioning like a regular human being, but it kind of has. My dad is in the process of installing a bath and shower combo because at first we only had a shower. We just had a glass shower. It was a corner shower. It was nothing special. It did the job, but obviously I have a baby in the house now. My niece, I live with my niece, and yeah, it's not that convenient trying to shower a toddler. she doesn't like the shower, I don't think. So yeah, my dad's in the process of doing that, but it is taking a lot longer than expected, and I haven't been able to shower regularly. I showered for the first time in 5 days yesterday, and yeah, it was the best shower I've ever had because I was craving one so badly. Yeah, I went to my boyfriend's parents' house to have a shower, so fucking God bless them, because holy shit, I was feeling disgusting. My hair has never been that greasy before. And I mean, like, I've skipped showers before due to like, you know, I've skipped showers for like, I don't know, 4 days or so due to depression and stuff like that. But usually when you know, I'm skipping showers because of that, it's because I have no motivation to. But like, this time it was literally out of my hands, you know, like I could not have a shower because I did not have one in my house, and that just made it so much worse. But anyway, I don't stink anymore, so that's cool. Hopefully my bath and shower gets put in. I was hoping it would be fixed today, but I don't think it's going to be, but it's fine. It's 6 days without a shower in the house. I'll be okay. I don't even know why I started rambling about that. Oh, I haven't been functioning as a human being. That's why. I don't know. For some reason, not having a shower in the house has made me, like, just want to not do anything. I don't want to get myself ready for the day. I don't see the point. I feel gross. Why should I make myself look not gross if I feel gross, you know? Do you catch my drift? But yeah, I actually don't know, like, what made me lead into how I haven't been functioning like a regular human being recently, but that's fine. Anyway, the name of this house is like Cozy Tones or something like that. Cozy Tones, air quote, starter home is probably what I'm naming it. Yeah, I don't know. I wanted to make this house quite like warm on the inside. I did a few things differently in this house. You can probably see right now if you're watching the video. If you're not watching the video and you're listening to the video and you have something on in the background, maybe just have a quick little peek at the screen. You see those on the floor? Those are tiles. Mm-hmm. Tiles in the kitchen. I never do that. I usually use the same wooden floor all throughout the entire house, but you know what? I was feeling a little bit adventurous today. I was like, I'm going to put tiles in this kitchen and I'm going to make this house look slightly different from the rest of my houses, because listen, I'm very well aware that all of my houses are starting to look the same, but there's kind of like a reason for that, you know? Like, I have a house style. It's this. It's this wooden flooring. It's this wallpaper. It's this tone of wood. It's just, I have a style. This is my style. My houses all look the same for a reason. I used to have people like, honestly, I used to have people get angry at me about it on my old YouTube channel. People got angry at me for everything on my old YouTube channel though. But yeah, I really had people get shitty with me because all of my houses looked the same. Yeah, I'm getting back to that point now. All of my houses are looking the same. I'm very well aware of it, and I am not overly apologetic about it because they look nice. If you put all of my houses on a street together, they look nice. Okay, the street looks pretty. It looks good. I don't know. They match. I like matching things. But yeah, I kind of want to, I was talking about this on stream today. I sort of want to decorate. I used to do this thing on my old YouTube channel called Let's Renovate Evansdale County. Sort of want to do that again because Evansdale County is my absolute favorite world in The Sims 3, and I always just want to do things in it. So yeah, I kind of want to, I want to start that up again and just like make all of the houses in Evansdale County look like my style. And then like maybe upload a save file of it. I don't know. That'd be kind of cool. Would you be interested in seeing that? Let me know in the comment section down below. But yeah, I don't really have an awful lot to say today. The only thing I really had to like update you on. By the way, I don't like talking about my houses. If you're new to my videos, I really don't talk about the build that much in my videos. I prefer to ramble and treat my commentaries as more like a podcast, I guess. I don't know. This is like my little chance to just spew everything out and you can just listen and just nod away and be like, yep, mm-hmm, I feel her on that one. I feel her. Or you can just mute me and put music on and ignore me and watch the build if that tickles your fancy. But yeah, I don't know. I like the chill podcasty vibes of my videos personally. Not that I watch my own videos. I do sometimes. Don't tell anybody. Anyway. Well, okay, not these videos. I watch my old videos sometimes for inspiration or to like motivate myself a little bit. I don't know. There's something about watching old motivated me that like motivates current me. Do you know what I mean? Like back in 2016, which is kind of yo, I really can't let go of 2016. I am seriously out here trying to recreate 2016 Sims YouTube. I've said this like in the past few commentaries, but I cannot let 2016 go. 2016 Sims YouTube was the best, okay? 2016 Sims in general was kind of the best, or 2016 Sims 3 was kind of the best, because it was like at that period where there were people still playing it and making content on it, but like it wasn't oversaturated, you know what I mean? So like not everybody was doing The Sims 3. Most people had moved on to The Sims 4, but there were still like Simblers and, you know, Sims tubers, I guess we're called. I don't know. Does anybody use that phrase? Sims tuber? I don't know. But yeah, there was like a good amount of Sims 3 creators still, but not so much that like, I don't know, you were overwhelmed by all of the creators around. And 2016 Sims YouTube was so good. And just 2016 Sims 3 was so good. I mean, there was drama. I saw fighting on my Tumblr dashboard pretty much daily, but you know, you're gonna get that regardless because it's the internet. People like to pick fights. But oh, I just miss it so much. So yeah, not sure why I went on to rambling about that. Oh, because I watch my old commentaries. I watch my old videos sometimes to listen to my old commentaries because yeah, I don't know. Hearing how like in the zone and how motivated I was back then just sort of gives current me a little bit of a kick. It's like, look how good she was. Look how motivated she was. She's doing good. Be like her. And then I do be like her. And actually, I do better than her because my builds are better than hers. look, Kiwi Simming had some okay builds, but some of them are really fucking ugly. Like, I could not roof for shit. I still kind of can't, but my roofs in my really old houses on my Kiwi Simming channel, absolutely terrible. I had someone once, I remember reading this comment while I was at work, and yeah, they insulted my roofing. They were like, I really like your builds, but all of your roofs are so ugly. Like, you really don't know how to roof. And I remember thinking about that comment for the rest of the day. I remember thinking about that comment while I was trying to get to sleep that night. I remember thinking about it the next morning. And yeah. Mm-hmm. Became a little bit insecure about my roofs after that. Needless to say, the apartment builds started to kick off after that because obviously don't have to deal with roofing in apartments. But yeah. Shout out to that person who insulted my roofing back in 2016. I've gotten better. It's still hard in this game. Okay. So like, in my past self-defense, I mean, she did have no sense of like decent roofs, but The Sims 3 roofing is hard. It's you don't have the freedom of roofing like you do in The Sims 4. That is one thing that I do like better about The Sims 4 than The Sims 3 is the roofing, because you know, you can just customize it so much in The Sims 4. You can't do that in The Sims 3. Yeah, my Sims 3 roofs still are not perfect, but it's because of the game. It's not my fault. I can't help it. I do my best with what I've got. But yeah, I've definitely gotten a lot better with that. So that's nice to know that people probably won't insult my roofing anymore. Oh, one thing that I was going to mention that I'm sure I'll get comments on in this video, because this is the first video I've posted where I have it. Look at my UI. I installed the clean UI mod. It's still in beta, so it's not like perfect. As you can see, that little bit on the left, that's blue. Once it's like finished, that'll be the same color as the rest of the UI. But again, it's in beta. It's not finished. But isn't it so cute? I love it so, so much. In live mode in particular, it looks really, really nice because live mode is pretty much finished, I think. Yeah, they've recolored pretty much everything in live mode. It's just creator style, Cass, this little bit of build by, and I think a few other things that they haven't quite gotten around to, you know, updating for this UI. But it's really, really cute. I love it so, so much. I'm so excited for it to be finished. I'm really glad that I put that in my game because, oh, it just looks so nice. It's so clean. It's called the Clean UI mod, if I didn't say that already. I'm going to leave a link in the description. I started my CC Tumblr again, kind of. I also kind of started my Tumblr again, just because, again, I'm trying to recreate 2016, I guess. But no, I made a page on my CC Tumblr that has every single game mod, not like custom content. So not clothing, not like hairs and, you know, fancy things like that, but like just my game mods, I have those linked on this one page, and it includes the UI mod. So I'm going to leave the link to that in the description if you're interested in downloading that mod or just interested in looking at the mods that I use in general, because yeah, there's a few of them. They're mostly NRAS and a few gameplay mods here and there. Also my some like little aesthetic-y things here and there, just like mods, not like custom content. If I could link every single thing in my mods folder, I would, but I just have far too many I have far too many pieces of custom content to like start trying to link my custom content, so that's just never gonna happen. But yeah, if you're interested in following my CC Tumblr, by the way, you can absolutely do that. The link is koeccc.tumblr.com. I'll leave that linked in the description as well for those of you who are interested. And yeah, there's also koeccc.tumblr.com where I'm uploading my own houses, and I'm probably gonna share screenshots of the Coopers, because I don't know, I just miss having a blog. But anyway, we're pretty much finished with the house and are getting ready to jump into some screenshots. So I'm gonna wrap my commentary up right here. I really hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please be sure to give it a big thumbs up for me. The download for this house will be in the description if you are interested in downloading it. And actually, we're not even, okay. I thought we were closer to wrapping up the video than we actually are. I was looking at the wrong time. Thought the video was 16 minutes and 4 seconds long. It's actually 16 minutes and 58 seconds long. This is embarrassing. Anyway, ramble, getting a little bit closer to the end because I'm stupid. Whatever. The download link for this house is in the description, like I just said, if you want to check it out. Yada yada yada, this was built in Ann Arbor. There will be a link to that in the description as well, along with the link to One More Slot Please. Yada 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 yada. Anyway, I love you all so much. Thank you for watching this video. Be sure to give it a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. And yeah, I hope you have a beautiful rest of your day. And of course, I will see you next time. Bye-bye. Should I get up? Should I get up?